got top six answers on the board. We asked 100 men, name something you like your girlfriend to do to your face. Okay.
Rub it. Kiss it.
Kiss it. Harlan. I would know that because one of my favorite, all-time favorite comedians is George Carlin, but he didn't.
That's what I tell people, George Carlin. George Carlin.
When I was a kid, man, it was Richard Pryor and George Carlin. That was it. That was it, them two dudes. Anyway, talk to 100 men. Name something you like your girlfriend to do to your face.
Tickle it?
Tickle
good
it.
Answer.
Davina, how are you?
I'm good, Steve.
Talk to 100 men. Name something you like your girlfriend do to your face.
I'm gonna say lick it.
There you go.
Yeah, we're getting there. Oh, we're starting to get there now. Lick it! Hey, Cynthia, talk to 100 men. Name something you like your girlfriend to do to your face.
I'm gonna say take a picture of it.
Take a picture of it. Two strikes, we gotta be careful now, Greg. 100 men, name something you like your girlfriend to do to your face.
I'm gonna say sit on it.
Yes! How in the hell? Number one. Sit on it! Everybody feels better now. You've got two strikes. Fisher family can steal. Those people over there. We asked 100 men, name something you like your girlfriend to do to your face.
I'm gonna say blow on it. Steve, blow on it.
Blow on it! We asked 100 men, name something you like your girlfriend to do to your face.
We gonna say, motorboat, Steve.
Six answers on the board. Here we go. Name something that's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss. Sade.
Take your clothes off.
Take your clothes off.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. All right now, Miss Carol, give me something that's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss.
Open wide.
Good answer, good answer. Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
Okay, Gary. guess you like that. Gary said, good answer. Good answer, baby. My favorite answer. Open wide. Good answer, baby. Yeah. Colinthia,
yes.
Let me stop all this sense of humor over here. I went to Colinthia, she was like this.
I'm thinking, Steve.
Yeah, damn ready. That old joke you telling Mr. Funny. Colinthia?
Yes.
Name something that's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss.
Get on the scale.
Get on the scale. Get on the scale! That was a good answer, though. Eric,
right.
Name something that's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss.
How about bend over, Steve?
Come on now. Come on now. Bend over.
Gary, give me something it's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss.
Check my ear.
Come here, let me check your ear. All right now, Sade, come on now, listen to me. We got two strikes, need to be careful here, the other family can steal. Name something it's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss.
Pay me.
Pay my bill.
Oh, pay your bill.
Pay, like,
oh, okay,
bill.
I got you, I got you. Pay the bill. Oh. All right, family, name something it's okay for your doctor to ask you to do, but not your boss.
Lay down.
Lay down. Number five.
Turn it off.
Four.
Lose weight.
Three.
Answer personal questions.
These top eight answers on the board. Here we go. We ask 100 women. Name a traffic sign that describes you when making out in a car. Jesse.
Stop.
Stop.
I'm gonna say yield.
Yield. Pass the play. They're gonna play. All right, Robert Jr. Talk to 100 women. Name a traffic sign describes you when you make it out in the car.
Green, go.
Green, go.
Go.
All right. Yeah. 100 women. Name a traffic sign that describes you when you're making out in the car.
I'm gonna say slow down, Steve.
Slow down. Ashley, we talked to 100 women. Name a traffic sign that describes you when making out in a car.
Danger.
The traffic sign that says danger. Robert Senior, 100 women. Name a traffic sign that describes you when you're making out in a car.
Steve, I'm gonna say slippery when wet.
Well, Pastor, y'all ever had a prayer vigil at the church?
Yes.
You're gonna have another one. The pastor said it's slippery when it's wet. First lady?
Yes.
Yes. I'm scared of this one. We ask 100 women, name a traffic sign that describes you when you're making out in the car.
Pedestrian crossing.
So you just get something to start walking around the car? It's hot in here, Lord. Let me go. Pedestrian crossing. Oh. All right, Robert Jr., we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful, the other family can steal.
Ooh, hazard.
Oh, that's good. Good.
Hazard. Good. All right, family, talk to 100 women. Traffic sign that describes you when you're making out in the car.
We're gonna go with do not enter, Steve.
Yeah. We gonna go with do not enter. Number eight.
Bumpy road.
Number six.
Curbs ahead.
Number three. Answers on the board. Name something Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
She rubs it.
Woo! Rubs it.
We're gonna play, Steve. Yeah.
George, I was really disappointed in you.
I was disappointed myself, man.
You got a wife, I got a wife.
And I got the head.
Both of us got bald heads. And you sat there, didn't even move your damn hand. All right, Tiffany, name something that Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
She kisses your precious Steve. Yeah.
Say your answer again.
She kisses your precious head, Steve.
Kisses it.
Good answer.
Hey, Kathy.
Hey.
Name something Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
She shaves it.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Nah, that's not gonna happen. Not gonna give my wife a razor blade. No. Shaves it. Yeah. Eric, what do you do, man?
Steve, I'm an analyst for a major government contractor. I'm also a 13-year Army veteran and Bronze Star recipient.
Appreciate your service, man. Thank you, man. All right, Eric. Name something Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
Waxes.
Wax. Okay. Oh, okay. Wax it!
Every time.
All right, Christina, name something Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
Well, when she's angry at you, she slaps it.
Oh.
Smacks it. Name something Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
She admires it.
Good answer.
She admires it. Oh. Tiffany, only one strike. Name something Marjorie Harvey does to Steve's bald head.
She tickles it, Steve.
She tickles it.
Oh.
Kathy, one answer left, two strikes. Washington family can steal.
She hugs it.
Hugs it. All right, Washington family, let's go. Now, George, Dion is right there. Name something Marjorie does to Steve's bald head.
Wait, Steve. This is what Marjorie's gonna do.
Come on, boy.
I love every bit of it.
Lick it.
Yeah.
Lick it.
Every bit of it.
Number six. Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. Generation Right got 186. Warburton family not on the board. Give me Shelly, give me Lexi.
Shelly!
Ladies, point values are double. We've got the top five answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him it's too soon. Shelly.
His place, his apartment.
His apartment.
Hey.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Woo! DeFernando, my man. Name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him it's too soon.
On a trip.
On a trip, yeah.
Good answer, good answer. Whoa.
All right, here we go, darling. We ask 100 women, name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him it's too soon.
His parents' house.
His parents' house.
Yeah.
Wendy, we ask 100 women, name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him, well, it's too soon.
To a work function.
To a work function.
That's good.
Greg, we talked to 100 women. Name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him it's too soon.
An orgy?
Good answer. Good answer.
Why not? Good answer. Why not? Good job, honey.
Okay, okay.
Great answer. Hey,
to the orgy.
No. That's
that was an excellent answer.
Yeah, you gotta admit it would be too soon, though. Shelly, we got two strikes. We gotta be careful. The Warburton family can steal. All right? Talk to 100 women. Name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him it's too soon.
Church.
Yeah. To church.
Ah.
Church.
What? I'm dying to know what these other two answers are.
Wait a minute. So this is a unique situation. If it's there, you steal and you get the points. But if it's not there, Generation Ripe wins the game. Oh. We talked to 100 women. Name a place a guy wants to take you on a date, but you tell him it's too soon.
A nude beach.
This extended.
Okay.
We're going to the nude beach. Number right. five.
What?
What? That's what. That's the first place you go. Number three. Well, we want to thank the Warburton family for playing. We're going to make a donation to your charity just for hanging out with us today. Hey, I need two of you to play Fast Money. Give me two of you right here. I got Wendy and I got DeFernando. We're going for Fast Money right after this. Top seven answers on the board. Name something that Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Kavika. Eating all the cookies.
Eating all the cookies.
Delivering toys.
Delivering toys.
We got to play, Steve.
Okay, Tasha, name something Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Coming down the chimney.
Coming down the chimney. Name something Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Staying away from his wife.
Staying away from his wife. All right, Brock, we only got one strike. Name something Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Taking care of the reindeer.
Taking care of the reindeer. Toya, sixth grade math teacher. Name something Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Choosing the naughty kids.
Choosing the naughty kids. Shalonda, name something that Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Being jolly all the time.
Tired of being happy all the time. All right, Tasha, we got two strikes. The Sanborn family can steal. Name something Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Staying away from the ho-ho-hos. Good answer!
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer!
What? Staying away from the ho-ho-hos. Name something that Santa Claus might say was the hardest part of his job.
Managing the elves.
Managing the elves. Five.
Checklist
top 7 answers on the board. Can't wait to hear these. Name something a wife might admit she loves more than she loves her husband. Jay.
Money.
Wow. Money.
You're gonna play.
Wow.
You're
gonna play. Go ahead, Laura. Give me something a wife might admit she loves more than she loves her husband.
I'm gonna say her kids, Steve.
Good answer. Good answer.
Her kids. Laura, something a wife admits she loves more than her husband.
Steve, I am going to say her mother.
Yeah. Yeah.
Her mother. Gabby, name something a wife might admit she loves more than her husband.
Oh my God, I really hope my husband's not watching this one. What about her toys?
It's up there. Watch. Just watch.
Let me ask you this, Gabby. Did you just say, I hope my husband's not watching?
He's gonna have something to say about it, Steve. He's gonna have something to say. It's just an answer, Steve. It's just an answer. Not me, not me.
No. You say, I hope he's not watching. This is about you. Her toys! Jay is standing right next to you.
I know.
This, Ileana, could be a time to just take an X.
No way.
We can go on and stang him.
Yeah.
Jay, brace yourself.
Okay.
Name something a wife might admit she loves more than her husband.
Her shoes.
Yeah.
Hey, Jay. Jay. Now, Jay, I got a strong feeling that's gonna be up there. Don't take it personal, because all women love shoes.
Yeah.
Shoes! Yeah! Jay, 2 strikes, Morris family can steal.
Steve, I'm gonna say jewelry.
Yeah, good job.
Jewelry! All right, family. Name something a wife might admit she loves more than she loves her husband.
Okay, we got it.
Okay.
Most women like themselves better than
herself. Number 7. Four.
Food, liver.
Number 3.